I don't know about you, but I absolutely love watching these camera rig breakdowns, or whatever you want to call it, just to see how people rig out their camera systems. It doesn't even have to be a camera that I own, but sometimes I can find inspiration even from someone building out an Arri rig or Red or whatever the case may be. But the other reason is I'm just a camera nerd, and I love seeing camera rig builds. So figured I'd show you this build and kind of go over the components and all that kind of good stuff and kind of talk about why I have each of these, but I'm going to try to keep it as brief as possible because this is like my fifth time filming it and I keep rambling on and I don't want to do that. So rambling will ensue, but let's go ahead and get into it. And first of all, let's talk about the whole idea of this rig and how I use this rig mostly. And this is primarily like an easy rig mounted documentary style camera rig. Obviously, if it's for an interview and this is my A cam for the sticks, this isn't gonna be on here. I'm gonna just run this boomed overhead to get better audio. But for running gun style stuff, documentary stuff, all that B-roll, this is kind of how I run this rig. So let's go ahead and talk about it and kind of go through the different bits and bobs of said rig. First of all, on the back, I have a V-mount plate, it's Indie Pro Tools V-mount plate. Early on, I just decided to go with V-mount batteries, and that's what I've stuck with ever since. Now on the side, it has a D-tap out because I like to basically run power and power all my accessories from a D-tap from my V-mounts if I can. That way I don't have to worry about charging other batteries and all that kind of good stuff. Yeah, that's what I prefer. V-mount powering pretty much everything. Like right here is powering this monitor, which we'll get to here in a second. So speaking of this monitor, I guess we can just go ahead and get into it right now. It's a small HD 702 touch monitor. I absolutely love this monitor. It is touch screen, it's 1500 nits of brightness, and a 7-inch monitor. Once you go with a bigger monitor, it's really hard to go back to the smaller monitors. In fact, I don't even use this monitor on board unless I'm going to navigate through the menu to change resolution or something like that. Otherwise, this pretty much always stays closed. And with this little knob right here, I can navigate through most of the menu items while I'm looking at this. So I don't really see a huge need for this to be open. And it kind of protects the CFast card slots in here because that's what I use. I use CFast cards. I don't use the Samsung T5 drives or anything because I just find CFast is a little bit more reliable. So yeah, got the 702 touch. It is on this small rig swivel monitor mount thing. I'll leave all the links to these products, pretty much everything here is small rig, as you can see, and everything with the exception of this matte box and this follow focus I've purchased with my hard-earned money, but they were cool enough to send this this matte box and follow focus to test out and talk about, so we'll get to that here in a minute. But yeah, everything small rig, I'll leave a link to all these parts and stuff in the description, and a couple different places you can go. Film Tools, go check out Film Tools, the great folks over there, and then B&H, Adorama, all that kind of stuff. I'll leave links below so you can go shop wherever your heart desires. So yeah, we got the small rig monitor mount. It swivels and it articulates, so it's super helpful if you're getting high angle or low angle shots to just be able to swivel that. Depending on what angle you're on. I do find that this does loosen up over time, but I always have a multi-tool with me on hand, so I just tighten that up and always have that in my pocket, so it's really not that big of a deal. So that being said, the monitor mount is attached to this top handle, which is an absolute unit of a top handle. And I bought this top handle for a couple of reasons. This isn't the Ursa Mini Pro small rig top handle or thing. I think they actually have an Ursa kit, top handle kit, but I actually prefer this one for a couple of reasons. Number one, I like how big this handle is just for briefcase carrying between locations or moving from sticks to easy rig, whatever the case may be. I just love the fact that it's a much bigger handle and it just feels super robust. And the other thing is the fact that it has a closed front and back means that this is like a super unreasonable fear of mine, and it's not founded on anything other than paranoia. But when I put an easy rig on, or if I'm grabbing the top handle, if the camera's at this kind of angle or this kind of angle, I have this unreasonable fear that the camera is either gonna slide out of my hand, or that the easy rig, like the little spring-loaded clamp, I run an easy rig typically, and it has that spring-loaded clamp. I have this unreasonable fear that it's just gonna slide out. And I got this top handle thinking, you know what, if this thing slides, it's gonna get caught on either the front or the back, and it's gonna save this camera from falling to its death. And yeah, it's never ever happened to me, but I figured I'd be safer than sorry. So, and the other thing is that it's really easy to take on and off. You just flip this lever here, and it slides back and forth so you can adjust it, but it also has this little tab right here. Now it's all connected with this stuff right here, but you can take it off really easily and to pack it away and all that kind of stuff for travel. So I absolutely love this top handle. And then right here it has these 15 millimeter rod attachments. So if you don't run something here on the bottom and you still need rails for say like a wireless follow focus or something for a focus motor, you can do it like that. So as you can see on the side here, I've got these little things. Well, you probably can't tell because everything's black in this room. I don't know what I was thinking, but these are these little cable management things made by Sprig, and they just fit into the quarter 20 screw mounts and just keeps the rig like super clean. And you know, you don't hear any cables like rustling around or you know, flopping around or anything. Just kind of keeps everything nice and tidy and neat. I've got right now just have this power cable for the monitor and this SDI cable going down here, and just kind of keeps everything neat out of the way and unobstructed, because when I go to put the Easy Rig on, I don't ever want there something to be in the way when I go to attach it. I just want to be able to attach it really quickly. So it just keeps everything more streamlined and yeah, safer, all that kind of good stuff. So I think that's pretty much all we got on this side of the top handle. On this other side, I have a little cold shoe mount, small rig cold shoe mount right here. And then obviously I have a shotgun mic right here. Typically always have this on here, except for obviously when I'm doing an interview, this is gonna be boomed overhead for better audio. So that being said, let's move over to the other side. You can see I've got some Velcro here, and that is really to attach this right here. If I'm running more accessories where I need more than one D-tap out, I will run this little adapter and just kind of Velcro it right here so I can plug in a couple more accessories. If I'm running maybe a wireless transmission system that I'll put right here, or wireless follow focus, whatever the case may be, I could just run it all off one D-tap port. So just keeps everything a little bit more efficient on set. Below that, we have this side handle. This is also made by Small Rig. This plate is kind of loaded with all kinds of attachments. It has a NATO rail right here. So if you have maybe a handle or maybe a monitor mount or something with a NATO rail, you can use that. It has a cold shoe mount right here. And this is typically where I will put like a Mars 400S Pro to send a video feed out to a client if I got a video village set up, just depending on the shoot. So I put that right here, and it's still unobstructed if I need to use this side handle right here, which is attached to the Airy rosette plate that is kind of built into the side plate. Now I used to have the Tilta, well, I still have it, the Tilta Nucleus Nano system. And I used to have that right here, and I loved it because I had a record button, but I found that system to be very unreliable to the point where it just wasn't worth the energy fiddling with it to make sure it was all set up properly and to try to reconnect it after disconnects every 5 seconds. So I just kind of put that thing to the side, decided I'm just going to use that if I need first AC to pull focus. I've heard it disconnects more when it's so close to the motor or something. I don't really understand what's going on, but it's super annoying. So I've pretty much stopped using that, and I go back to just a old school follow focus, whatever. So, and I have this handle here, and it's much more robust. So when I'm on the Easy Rig and it's, you know, all the weight is pretty much held here, I use this handle as a great little side handle just to kind of balance things and kind of control the angle of the camera, control where the camera's going. And then I have the other hand on this follow focus to be able to pull focus. So yeah, I much prefer this handle over the Tilta one. So I think that's pretty much all with this side right here. Let's move on to the bottom of this rig and talk about that. So right here, this is a Zocular plate. This is for my FSB 8 fluid head. And I have that screwed into this Small Rig base plate here. Just takes 15 millimeter rails. You can see these right here. And the reason why I love this little plate, I actually got this when I was building out my Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 4K rig. And I got it because it has a 501 style plate attachment here. So the plate that it comes with is really small, but you can adapt it. You can use pretty much any other 501 plate on it. And it's got this little lock here, so it's not going anywhere. So what I did is I put a 501 style plate, little Manfrotto plate on the bottom of the camera. So I can slide that in here. And the reason why I like everything being really quick like that instead of screwing everything in is so if I were to go travel or whatever the case may be, it's just really quick to tear down and build back up. So I've got these 15 millimeter rails. These are pretty long. I don't remember the exact length of these, but on it I have this follow focus, and then I have this LWS matte box support attachment right here. So let's talk about this follow focus first. So first of all, one thing I really like is the fact that it has 2 points of rotation. And number one, it's helpful for if you're swapping lenses or something like that. You can actually just turn this and flip this thing out and then change your lenses. And the reason why that's nice is because it only mounts onto one rail, as you can see here. So if you're to loosen this one and it was on a tripod or something, the whole follow focus would just flop over. But if you just adjust or loosen up this one, you can just move it that way. So you can slide whatever lens is on and then put that back on, tighten it down, and then you're ready to go. So on here, you can see these two little screws. These are hard stops, and these are great for two purposes. Number one, if you're doing a pulling focus, if you're trying to hit marks, you can set A and B points. So what you do is you just loosen these up and set your focus one, tighten that screw down, find your next focus point, and then move this little screw to the next focus point so you can kind of have a good start and stop so you can kind of hit your focus on each take. The other thing it's really good for is if you have stills lenses like this right here, this is a Sigma 18-35 that does not have hard stops at infinity and minimum focus distance, you can set those up as your hard stop, so you can kind of create hard stops for your lens, which is really nice. So you're not gonna always try to go to infinity focus and then keep spinning and spinning and spinning. You know you're at your hard stop. So that's kind of how I use it on this lens. But if you're using a cinema lens that has a larger focus throw than something like this, then you can just flip this little tab up right here. And what that does is that just eliminates any kind of hard stops on the actual follow focus itself. So if you're using a cinema lens or something with a longer focus throw, you probably want to flip that up so you can actually get to minimum focus and to infinity focus and all that kind of good stuff. They have a couple other things that it ships with when you get it. If you don't have any focus gears on your lens, it does ship with one of these, which you kind of wrap around your lens. I personally like these little follow focus gears, which I think the company is follow focus gears or seamless gears or something like that, and just kind of wraps around the lens. But if you have cinema lenses, then that's already built on. All right, and lastly, let's talk about this matte box. So this is the Small Rig lightweight matte box, and it's actually pretty feature packed for, especially for the price. It's a little on the bigger side, so if you want to have a more compact matte box system, then they also have some like the mini matte box, which they just came out with, might be another good option, which I plan to do a comparison between the two here in the near future. So if you want to see that, let me know down in the comments below. But that being said, this is a really great system. It takes two filters. You can either use 4x4 or 4x5.65, and they're really good. And I think a lot of people don't really realize the benefit of a matte box system, even if you don't want to use any kind of diffusion filters or anything that in front of your lens. It's still a good idea to have a matte box because you can use something like this, like right here, this little filter right here. This is just a clear filter from Nisi. It was 30 bucks and it's just a protective filter. So if you're doing any kind of thing where you're following a car in a scene or a motorcycle or something and they want to kick up dirt or something like that, if you have a cinema lens or like a fisheye lens or something that doesn't take filters on the front, you can use this as like a protective filter to protect the front element of your glass. So you don't destroy your glass, you destroy a $30 filter. But the fact that it has two slots, two trays, means that you can put two filters in here. So if you run a camera that's really prone to IR pollution, like the Blackmagic cameras, you can put an IR cut filter in there. And then you can put something like a Hollywood Blackmagic or Tiffin Black Pro Mist or something like that to kind of add diffusion or anything like that and take the digital edge ledge off of whatever camera that you have, or if you just have a set of IR NDs like Nisi, they make really good ones. If you have a set of those that you prefer to use, you can run those in here as opposed to using the internal NDs on your camera. Now, the way it works is that actually attaches to a 114 millimeter outside diameter, and small rigs send you these little things right here. These actually screw onto the front of your lens. So like your stills lenses right here, you just screw onto the front of the lens, and then the matte box actually fits over this, clamps on top of that, and then there's a tie down point, a tightening point to be able to clamp it down so it's nice and secure. Now, if you have a lens that doesn't extend while you are zooming in and out, like this 18 to 35, I recommend getting this right here. This is a little, basically just a matte box support, and I'll leave the part number, like I said, in the description. And this just kind of keeps things all tightened together and just a little bit more secure, just so, just kind of help alleviate some of the added weight, especially if you have a heavy lens or something like that. And then lastly, it has a little flag right here, which is really great to help with flaring and all that kind of good stuff. So that is, that's pretty much the, this rig. This was still a long video. I don't really know how to make this shorter, and other than just saying like I have this year. So hope you're still here. If you are, I really appreciate it. I'm fully aware that there's a guitar mount that's been pretty much sticking out of the top of my head this entire video, but I already set it up. So anyways, if you have any questions about this rig, or just want to tell me how much you like this rig, then let me know down in the comments below. If you have a If you have any suggestions on how to make this rig better, then definitely let me know. And that's pretty much it. Appreciate you watching. I'm fairly positive you're not here anymore, because this has been a long video, I guarantee it. So anyways, love you guys. Thank you so much. And gals, thank you so much for watching this video, and I hope to see you in the next video. If you want to see a comparison of the lightweight matte box and the mini matte box, let me know down in the comments below. And if you want to see a rig build out of the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 6K Pro, let me know down in the comments as well, and I'll put one of those videos together for you in the future, maybe near future, who knows. But other than that, thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one. Peace.